This video is on TQM, that means Total Quality Management. I have made this video with all detailed explanations so that you can understand TQM very easily. Hello viewers, this is Rajiv Bhoumik. You are watching my channel Make Things Easy. You will get lot of useful videos in my channel. I make those videos for you. So please motivate me. You can motivate me by subscribing my channel, by liking my videos, by sharing my videos. And while subscribing, please press the bell icon so that you can get intimation whenever I upload any video. And watch this video till the end. Let us understand TQM. T for total, Q for quality, and M for management. Total means involvement and input of everyone in the organization, top management to its employees. Now what is quality? Fully meeting customer needs and requirements all the time. Now what is management? The way we act and operate our policies and procedures, including our training and instruction to all our employees. Now I will tell you objective of TQM or why TQM to be implemented in an organization. Customers get a quality product or services, increase productivity, lower the manufacturing cost or service cost, ensure competitive position in the market, achieve employee satisfaction, provide job security to its workforce, enhance higher profit and growth of business. Now I will tell you defining of TQM for an organization. Art of managing the business to achieve excellence, an enhancement to the traditional way of doing business, a philosophy to improve the organization continuously, a method to meet customer needs now as well as in future. It integrates management techniques and technical tools with a disciplined approach. Now I'll tell you about TQM principle. TQM should be customer focused. Leadership played a major role in TQM. People's involvement is very much required in TQM. Everybody should get involved in TQM. Process approach should be there. Strategic and systematic approach of management is very much required in TQM. Continual improvement is required for TQM, that is Kaizen is very much required. Factual approach for decision making, that means decision should be made based on data, and then mutually beneficial supplier relationship. So these are the principles of TQM. Now I will tell you about the basic six concepts of TQM. A common and involved management to provide long-term support. Focus on internal and external customer. Effective utilization and involvement of entire workforce. Continuous improvement of all processes. Treating supplier as partners, establish performance measures for the processes. Now let us see what are the elements of TQM. Customer satisfaction, do it right first time. Some people call it FTR, that is first time right. Then continuous improvement through Kaizen. Then employee involvement, then empowering of staff, because only employee involvement will not be sufficient. You need to empower them also. Then benchmarking, that means there should be some target against improvement should be done. And then feedback mechanism, that means after every improvement there should be some feedback. In TQM, we are talking about continuous improvement. Now, what is this continuous improvement? There are so many quality gurus like Edward Deming, Joseph Moses Zoran, then Philip Crosby, then Kaoru Ishikawa, and many more. They have given their various concepts and techniques for continuous improvement. Let us see few concepts and techniques. 7 QC tools, 14 points of quality management, Kaizen, SQC, that is statistical quality control, quality circle, zero defect, PDCA, that is plan, do, check, act, COPQ, that means cost of poor quality, 7 deadly diseases, etc. So by implementing these concepts and techniques, continuous improvement can be done in TQM. Now I will tell you what are the limitations of TQM. TQM implementation or getting the benefit from TQM may differ from company to company. It may require more money to implement TQM. It may require more time to implement TQM. Fear of changing the traditional approach and going towards TQM. So all these things will create uncertainty, fear and doubt in employees' mind. So these are the limitations of TQM. Let us see what are the benefits of TQM. It makes a company a leader in the market. It makes a company more sensitive to customer needs. In TQM culture, everyone is motivated to contribute. Customer believes that TQM supplier will supply quality products only. It makes a company ready to adopt. So, TQM makes effective contributions to achieve its objective. Toyota is one of the examples. So viewers, thanks for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe it and like this video, share this video. And if you want to comment some things, please leave your comment in the comment section. Thank you once again for watching this video.